Hey guys, welcome back to Dump and Chase. My name is Isaac, and today we're going to be discussing Herb Carnegie and why he could have been the first black NHL player. A man named Larry Berman recently won an auction for a letter written in August 1948 to Herb Carnegie. The letter was from the New York Rangers organization, from Frank Boucher, to request that Herb attended the training camp. So the letter actually was describing, "You are to report on Tuesday, September 14th, 1948, to the New York Rangers Hockey Club's training camp at Eagle's Nest, Saranac Lake, New York. You are instructed to obtain proof of your nationality in the form of a birth certificate and to present same along with the enclosed letter from this corporation to an office of the United States Immigration and Naturalization Service. These offices are located most of the principal cities of Canada, notably Montreal, Toronto, Winnipeg, Windsor, Regina, Calgary, and Vancouver. By submitting your birth certificate and the enclosed letter to one of these offices, you will be granted the necessary 29-day pass required to enter the United States. These instructions must be followed, otherwise you will not be permitted to cross the border." It goes on to tell him that they are enforcing these rules very strictly and that he needs to do this right away as soon as he can and not wait until the last minute. It asks that he will bring his own skates and any other equipment that might prove helpful to him, and if possible, have your skates sharpened so that you will not lose any time in getting onto the ice. Then it goes into detail on the transportation he will be taking, which is trains, and trusting that you will read this letter carefully and comply with the instructions outlined, and looking forward to seeing you at our training camp. I remain yours very truly, Madison Square Garden Corporation, Frank Bouchard, manager of the New York Rangers Hockey Club. So, this is the letter that was sent, and this was recently auctioned for $240 to Mr. Larry Berman, and he donated the letter to the Hockey Hall of Fame on Saturday. Carnegie, the son of Jamaican immigrants to Canada, he was a very good centerman who played in the Quebec Provincial Hockey League, the Quebec Senior Hockey League, and the Ontario Hockey Association Senior A League, and is widely considered to be the best black player to never play in the NHL. He played for the Quebec Aces in 1949-53, where he was a teammate of Jean Beliveau. He attended Rangers training camp in September 1948 and turned down three contract offers because they paid less than he was making in Quebec in his other professional hockey league. The final offer would have required him to play the season at the Rangers' top minor league affiliate in New Haven, Connecticut, nearly 2 hours from Madison Square Garden. Bernice Carnegie, the daughter of Herb, said her father rejected the offers because he had a wife and a growing family to support in Quebec and couldn't afford the pay cut. Unfortunately, he was in a time where black people were not treated very well. So he did get some very bad racism. He was a black man playing hockey in the 40s and 50s. He endured his share of racism, according to Wikipedia. One famous 1938 incident, Conn Smythe, the owner of the Toronto Maple Leafs, actually said, as he watched him play as a member of the Toronto Young Rangers, he is alleged to have either said that he would accept Carnegie on the team that he were white, or if he would pay $10,000 to anyone who could turn him white, which is a very racist thing to say. And now there are some actual doubt that has arisen to whether he did indeed utter this remark, but according to multiple reports, he did say this, and this is not good. Herb's grandson, Rain, who had a very successful junior career, however, he went undrafted, Rain did, Herb's grandson, and he now plays in the AHL, most recently with the Admirals. So, This man could very well have been the first African American NHL player. He was offered a contract with the top minor affiliate, but he wouldn't have made as much as he would at his league back home, and he could have played in the NHL if he would have accepted that contract. I guarantee they would have brought him up for at least a couple of games. But there has recently been a movement to get him into the Hall of Fame sometime soon, which is he very well deserves that, and I think he should be in the Hall of Fame. Like I said, as many believe, he was the best black player to not play in the NHL. That's all I've got for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this little piece of history I'm digging up in this video. I did a lot of research for this video, and I learned a few new things, and I hope you guys did too. Thanks, guys, for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Make sure to like this video and subscribe. See you in the next video. Goodbye.